How do I determine a shortlink's destination? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. If you're not getting my weekly emailed Confident Computing newsletter, you're missing out on answers to problems and recommendations for things to do to keep you safe. Visit askleo.com/newsletter to sign up and learn more. Let's read the question. Before deleting spam, I often hover over the link to see where it is supposed to take me. These days, most spammers use a tiny URL. Is there a way to find out the real URL without clicking on it? Indeed, there are a couple of ways. I want to show you a couple of them after explaining just what it is a tiny URL or link shortener really is all about. To begin with, I want you to be skeptical of links in email. It's unfortunate, but the sad reality is that they can be deceiving. Particularly URL shortened links can take you to places you didn't expect to go. If you're getting email from people you trust, this is less of a problem, but especially if there's any concern whatsoever about the veracity of the sender, definitely take some extra steps to keep yourself safe. And one of those might be investigating exactly where a link is going to take you before it takes you there. What is a shortened link anyway? Well, let's have a look at the actual article on which this video is based, because I've got some good examples there. Here is a very, very long link. It is a link to google.com. It's actually a link to Google Maps. It's a pin on Microsoft corporate headquarters. Now, you can tell, of course, that that's very, very long. If you had to type it, you wouldn't be able to type it accurately. More interestingly, you'll notice that it has wrapped. In other words, it is longer than the page is wide. This is very common in email. Depending on your email program, that wrapping can actually cause the link to no longer work. Everything after the first line break gets kind of ignored, and everything before that line break, well, it's not enough. It's incomplete. It's a broken link. So one of the things we try to do when faced with long links like this is to use URL shorteners. Tiny URL is one of them. Bitly is another one you may have seen. There are others. I happen to have my own. So you can see down here, I've got something that is called go.askleo.com/msredmond. This takes you to the same place as that longer link. In fact, if I click on it, you can see it brings up Google Maps with Microsoft pinned right there. So it worked. It took me to that same nice long link. That's what a link shortener or URL shortener is all about, giving you a nice, short, manageable link to take you to something that is much more long, cumbersome, and error prone. So when you want to know where a link is about to take you, well, for example, if you were to take a look at go.askleo.com/msredmond, there's no way to know where it's going to take you until you click on it. Mostly. In fact, if you take a look at this other one, go.askleo.com/mystery, I'm not going to tell you where it goes. I'm not going to investigate where it goes. I'll let you find that one out for yourself. It's safe, trust me, but that's what a spammer would say, right? That's what someone who's trying to mislead you would say about a link like that. They would use terminology or words or phrases that would lead you to believe that the link is genuine and goes to some place you expect, when in fact it's probably taking you to something you didn't expect, or worse, something that is dangerous, something that looks like what you expect but isn't what you expect at all. That's why we're wanting to understand how to get there from here without actually having to get there. So tiny URL, for example, has a couple of different approaches. This tinyurl.com/preview.php, what that allows you to do, and again, I will go ahead and go there, is actually lets you enable previews. That sets a cookie on your browser. So if you clear cookies, or if you use a different browser, if you use a different machine, you'll have to do this for each one of those situations. But once that cookie is set, rather than taking you to a destination, TinyURL will first take you to an interstitial page that will show you where you're about to go. That's great, especially if there's only one hop involved. Many spammers use multiple hops. In other words, they'll use TinyURL to go to something else that goes to something else that goes to something else. But for the simple case, this works well. The other one is Bitly. The other popular one is Bitly. And what a lot of people don't understand about Bitly is that anybody can see a bunch of information. Here's a Bitly link that takes you to a place. In fact, as I am reading this and as I'm discussing this with you, I actually don't remember where I set it to go. We'll find out in a minute. But you'll notice that this second instance of that Bitly link simply adds a plus sign to the end of the link. If we click on that, once again, rather than going to its actual destination, we're going to a page about the link that may or may not show you a bunch more information about it. This link happens to go to buyleoalatte.com. No big surprise. Here's the link. Here's the actual destination. It used to be, and in some cases it may still be, that if you use that plus sign, you'll actually be able to view some interesting statistics about the link. In this case, it's protected, but it's taking me to somewhere that is at least telling me where that link is about to go before I go there. If I wanted to go there, I could now click on either of these and it would just take me to the final destination. But again, we know where we're going before we went there. Other link shortening services may or may not have this kind of functionality. There's one more thing I want to show you, and that's this service called Get Link Info. I'm going to start by copying my MS Redmond link into the clipboard and then going to Get Link Info. Get Link Info is a general purpose solution. It will show you where your link is about to go. I'm going to paste it here, hit Get Link Info. It does whatever it does, and it'll show me exactly where I'm going to go. It got redirected exactly once from go.askleo/msredmond to the google.com long URL. Now, Get Link Info specifically will show you if there are multiple hops. In other words, that scenario where I mentioned where a Bitly link goes to a tiny URL link, goes to some other link, that will all be documented step by step with the information presented by Get Link Info. I have to caution you, when I originally wrote this article some years ago, there were three services that would show you where a link went to. As of this update, there's only the one that's still working. These things come and go. So be aware that Get Link Info may disappear someday. There may be other solutions that you can find someday, but the solutions are out there. There are things that will show you where a link is going to take you, given the short URL that you're given. Now, there's one other thing I wanted to talk about, and that is, of course, why use short links at all, besides just making them shorter. So to be clear, I use my own link shortener, go.askleo.com. But I do that for two reasons. One is links get shorter. They're easier to remember. MS Redmond is much easier to remember than the whole Google URL. But I'll even use it sometimes where the resulting link is longer. And that's because redirection services like TinyURL, like Bitly, like any of the others, and like go.askleo.com actually let people know, let the users know that the link was clicked on and from what IP address. I don't track the IP address, I don't care about it, but I do care about how many people clicked on that link. If you click on a direct link that just goes somewhere, I never hear about it. But if I send that link through my go.askleo.com, I get link tracking. I get to know how popular that link was, how important that link was. And if the destination ever changes, which as it turns out happens from time to time, especially with Microsoft links, I can change the redirection. I can change the information stored at go.askleo.com to be the updated destination without having to go to all of the different articles in which I might have referenced go.askleo.com/msredmond. So it's also a nice way to save me a lot of time and help keep links as up to date as possible as they change over time. But this really does boil down to a very useful technology, be it for link shortening or link tracking, that has been, I'll just say, abused by hackers and spammers, because they can use it too. They can use it to cloak the destination of the links you're about to click on. So whenever you're uncertain, use some of the techniques that I've outlined here to understand exactly where that link is about to take you so that you can know whether or not you really want to go there. Hope this was helpful. Hope it was informative. Hope it keeps you a little bit safer on the internet as we click on our links in our email and elsewhere. For updates, for related links, for comments, and of course much more, visit askleo.com/10356. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.